Hi, this presentation is going to briefly distinguish estimates from predictions, projections, and forecasts, terms that are often used, perhaps inappropriately, as interchangeable. An estimate is any value thought to describe a population, and that can be a single point in time, or it can be a trajectory of data through time. A prediction is a statistical model that uses some kind of data, and that means, and that implies, studying the past. A forecast takes a predictive model and tries to extrapolate into the future. But forecasts, although they're not always reliable, at least try to use data-driven predictive models. Projections are the most dangerous territory because they're not based on data, they're based on assumptions. And the only time we would try to do that is if there are no data available to make our informed guesses. So we'll say a little bit more about each of these. The term estimate is actually a statistical term, and it implies some kind of inference, moving from a sample to a population, or from a mathematical function to a population. One way or the other, we're trying to make a guess about how a population behaves based on data. And the term statistical significance is used to assess the validity of an inference as we move from a guess to the actual parameter. Now, a population census is a survey of an entire population, so what it produces are not estimates. It produces parameters because you have the entire population mapped out. But the American Community Survey that is conducted by the U.S. Census uses random sampling to identify a subset of the population, so it does produce sample estimates and will rely upon inferential statistics. If we look at prediction, the notion here is developing a predictive model, and predictive models can be aimed at explaining a single or multiple outcomes or dependent variables. And those are predicted using a set of independent variables. That can be done using multiple regression, can be done using path models, structural equation models, and can be done using single points in time or using longitudinal regression models, which takes us from data point to data trajectory. And the usefulness of a predictive model is it gives us an equation. And when we move on to forecasting, the equations become important because as we extrapolate from predictive models into the future, we don't have future data. That's impossible. We can't collect something that hasn't happened yet. But we can use our equations to anticipate how things are going to change. And that's more effective if we have longitudinal predictive models from longitudinal regression. So essentially, the basic idea of forecasting is once an equation is found from a predictive model, it can be used to anticipate the future. But there's a big assumption there that assumes nothing else changes in the world that alters how our predictive model functions. And that's a big assumption. And if you've ever heard the phrase, the historical patterns are not good predictors of future patterns, well, that is something to keep in mind. But when we're looking into the future, it's always a gamble. So a lot of times what you see is in the field of demography, when we're predicting and forecasting population, that instead of giving a single forecast, there'll be multiple forecasts given based on different sets of conditions. That brings us finally to projections. And projections are probably the most dangerous type of thing to make. Because while a forecast is at least based on a model, some kind of data created the model, projections are used based on assumption. And that means there's no data available with which to develop a forecast. So why would we ever make a projection? Sounds like a really risky endeavor. Well, it may be necessary if we're looking very far into the future, where we've far outstripped any kind of utility of a predictive model, or we're anticipating events that have never come to pass, such as what would happen if there was a natural disaster in an area where there had never been a natural disaster. And that's going to wrap up our brief distinction between estimates, predictions, projections, and forecasts. Thanks for watching.